How do cells work? Why do we develop the way we develop? What does replication mean? Basic science gets at fundamental questions of life. If you look back at our Byers awardees, they've gone on to outstanding careers that have changed our understanding of human biology.
Our lab works on how cells divide. Cell division is essential for so many aspects of life. So from development and growth, a baby starts with just one cell initially, and it divides into 2, 4, 8, and so on. And problems in cell division can impact us in all kinds of ways. Many cancers ultimately come from errors in chromosome segregation. I got excited about cell division late as a graduate student by reading a book called Landmark Papers in Cell Biology, where there was one person called Bruce Nicholas who was thinking about the problem in a very mechanical way, and he posed all kinds of great questions that have to this day pretty much not been answered. One molecule that our lab spent a lot of time learning about is called NUMA, and our lab found that this molecule can turn one molecular motor on called dynein to tell it when to walk and what to carry and where to go. The Byers Award allowed us to do things that otherwise would not have been possible, that we're now pursuing full-time and that have had a big impact on not just our lab, but the entire field.
In my lab, we're really interested in how the brain is developed, how is it maintained throughout our life. Dopamine is actually a very ancient small molecule neurotransmitter. So we study dopamine in its role in regulating behavior. We're also interested in the cells that produce dopamine, because these cells unfortunately degenerate in Parkinson's disease. We are able to study dopamine cells in zebrafish. Amazingly, the embryos are completely transparent. You could look at a lot of the cellular processes in real time. So we identified a very druggable target that we believe will slow down Parkinson's disease progression in a disease-modifiable way. We're really at the verge of making a really important contributions, I believe, to the cure of Parkinson's disease. The Byers Award really allowed us to follow our curiosity.
I think the best thing in science is when you realize you understand how something works for the first time. At least to your knowledge, you're the only person on the planet who sort of understands the little secret. And that's kind of a thrilling moment. The motivation is really just to solve puzzles, I think, and understand how basic biology works. The lab in the 50s and 60s had shown that capsaicin, which is the main pungent ingredient in chili peppers, activates a subset of nerve fibers that are involved in pain sensation. And people had used this for many years without really knowing what the molecular basis of it was. And so as a molecular biologist, like, you want to understand pain. This is the question to answer. This is like the holy grail of pain research. This great fellow came to my lab, Mike Caterina. He was working on a project that wasn't going so well. And so I said, why don't you try this project, you know, because to identify a receptor for capsaicin, it's risky, but boy, this would be exciting. So he took it on. Identifying this receptor and cloning it was a big step. I think then pursuing the biology is really what makes the story much more significant and fuller. All these other people who came to the lab after to pursue this area was what sort of led to recognition by things like the Nobel and other prizes.
The Nobel Assembly at Karolinska Institutet has today decided to award the 2021 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine jointly to David Julius and Artem Patakutyan.
I was among the first Byers Award recipients, and that fund allowed us to do an in vitro study using mice. That was a pretty key moment in this research, and I think an important point in the field in general.
curiosity-driven research, not necessarily targeted toward translation yet, clinical applications and all of that, is really important for the fundamental breakthroughs in science, and that's what you just elucidated. And it's unrestricted grants for that kind of research are really, really important.
Brooke is a relatively rare philanthropist and donor who understands the fundamental benefit of curiosity-driven science. The Byers Award, it just expands the horizons and what's possible to explore.